The black-armored Deathwatch space marines roam the galaxy in search of aliens, destroying Xenos in the name of the Emperor. Welcome to this video where we're going to show you how to take your Deathwatch space marines from battle-ready standard up to parade-ready standard. Now you'll notice our model here is already painted to battle-ready standard. If you want to know how to do that, go and check out our battle-ready Deathwatch video. Now first thing we're going to be painting here is the armor. It's already black, so we're going to highlight it now with Dark Reaper first, followed by another highlight of Thunderhawk Blue. For both of these, we're using our small layer brush. Let's get started. Let's take some Dark Reaper from the pot and onto our palette here. Now, here is a base paint. We're going to mix a little bit of water in just to help thin it down so it becomes a highlight much easier. Then get a nice point on our brush and it's onto our Deathwatch Marine. Here, we're going around all the sections of the armor, providing a nice line highlight like so. Just carefully highlighting the edges of all the armor like this. Just working our way around all the armor plates of the black armor like this. Carefully picking out the highlight. Take your time as you're doing this. Try not to make a mistake, but have that pot of abandoned black on hand just in case you do. Next up, it's a highlight of Thunderhawk Blue, here being applied to the very edges of each of the black armor panels. So use the edge of the brush like this to pick out the very, very edges like this, making sure we're leaving some of the Dark Reaper showing too. There we go, that's the black armor sections done. Alright, up next let's have a look at painting the metal areas of our miniature. Now we'll start off by highlighting the silver bits with Iron Hand Steel. Then we'll put Liberator Gold onto the golden areas before highlighting both silver and gold with Stormhost Silver. First of all, that Iron Hand Steel, and for this grab your small airbrush again. Let's take some paint from the pot and onto our palette. As always, we're going to add a touch of water here to help thin it down. Make sure it goes on real smooth and subtle. There we go. Perfect. Then onto our miniature. Here, we're actually highlighting these areas we've got on the miniature, such as the shoulder pad here with this Iron Hand Steel. So it's picking out the very, very edges. Use the edge of the brush here like so, just to pick out the edges like this. Going around all the metal areas, including the arm, the silver, and don't forget the Aquila on his chest as well. Next up, we've got Liberator Gold, and here we're using it as a layer on the golden areas. So just layering up on top of what we've already got. On the shoulder pad here, we're going to leave this small corner here the darker colour, and the rest of it will highlight up with this Liberator Gold. And last on the metal, we've got a touch of Stormhost Silver, which we're going to use as a highlight on the silver and gold areas. And all those areas, just take your time to make sure you're picking out the absolute edges, especially on the shoulder pad rims as they're quite thin. There we go, that's our metal areas done. Okay, up next let's have a look at painting those blue and red areas. We'll start off by highlighting the Marine's Ultramarine shoulder pad on the right. We'll start with a highlight of Altdorf Guard's blue, followed by a highlight of Kalgar blue. After that, the red areas, including the gun casing. Here we'll start off with a highlight of Wazdaka red, followed by a highlight of Squig orange. First of all, it's that Altdorf Guard blue. For this, we're using our small airbrush. Let's grab a little bit of paint from the pot and onto our palette. Now here we want it to be really thin, so quite a bit of water here, as it wants to be quite subtle when it goes on. Nice, nice point on the brush there as well. Then onto our Space Marine. Here, we're just applying a nice line highlight around the very inside of our shoulder pad. So just applying a highlight like this, very subtly on the inside of the Marine shoulder pad, all the way around like this. It's be quite subtle when it goes on, but that's absolutely perfect, is what we're after. Then a fine highlight of Kalgar blue just inside that one here, a really fine line just running up the center like this. Up next, we've got Wazdaka red, and here we're applying edge highlights to the gun casing. Next up, Squig orange. Here, use the edge of the brush to pick out the very, very edges of the gun casing. There we go, that's the gun casing done. Okay, let's finish the model off now with a few more details. First of all, let's highlight the leather up, first with Mournfang Brown, then with XV88. After that, we'll paint the lenses on his helmet, first with a layer of Mephiston Red, followed by a highlight of Trollslayer Orange. First of all, it's that Mournfang Brown. Grab your small airbrush for this one. Let's take some more paint from the pot and onto our palette. A little touch of water here will help those highlights be real smooth. Make sure we've got a nice point on the brush, then onto our marine. Here, we're just picking out the leather parts here. We're just picking out the very edges of the leather here with this Monfang brown. Just making sure of drawing a nice line around the pouches, the holster, and of course the belt too. Then we're using XV88 to highlight over the top of this. Use the edge of the brush here to pick out the very edges of all the leather bits. Next up, grab some Mephiston Red, and here we're painting the eyes of our Marine. Concentrate towards the front of the eyes like this, so you're leaving some of the corn red at the back. Then add a tiny dot of Troll Slayer Orange at the very front of your Space Marine's eye. With that, that's all of our details highlighted. We just need to now dry brush on top of the base to finish our miniature off. And for this, we'll be dry brushing it with a Shabti Bone. Grab your small dry brush for this. Let's take some paint from the pot. And as always with a dry brush, we're going to rub most of it off onto a piece of tissue paper down here. There we go. Perfect. Then onto our miniature. Here, we're just lightly dry brushing the top of our base with this Shabti Bone like so. You'll notice that all the sand detail gets picked out. Be careful here not to hit the feet of your miniature. Just be real careful as you get somewhere near the feet like this to work your way around very carefully. Okay, that's the base done. And with that, our Deathwatch Marine is parade ready and ready to take the fight to the enemies of the Emperor. And that's how you can take your Deathwatch Space Marines up to parade-ready standard. I hope you've enjoyed the video. Happy painting.